Hi, my name is Alex, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to design this Instagram post using Photoshop CC step by step. I made a similar tutorial a while ago. I'll be linking down below. So let's jump right in. I am having two monitors, so I'll move this on the second screen. You won't be seeing that. I get a new document. These are the numbers. This is the size for the Instagram post in portrait mode. Usually it's a square, 1080 by 1080. Like I was saying, I will look on the second monitor to remember what I did in the previous post. And I'll try to cut the video so you don't have to wait for me to get inspiration from that. So okay, let's begin. Let's make a background. Go to adjustment, go to solid color and input these numbers. Okay, let's add our texture in here like this. Make it bigger, hold shift. Okay, change the blending modes to, let's say, soft light. Okay, that's that. We need to add our burger. Right click, open with Adobe Photoshop. We need to cut our subject from the background. W, select subject. We just wait for Photoshop to do his thing. Now the Photoshop has done with selecting the burger, but we want to add the wooden table too. So we need to make another selection. Go to rectangle marquee tool, hold shift and drag like this. And now we have the wooden table too. Go to this, add layer mask. And now the subject is cut. Drag into our artboard. Ctrl T to transform it and make it smaller. Okay, something like that. Okay, maybe like this. Ctrl A to select all artboard. Just center it. Okay, now we need to add some light to our background. Go to subround brush. Choose the foreground color white. Just add some brush strokes. Go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Something like that. Maybe change the blending options to soft light overlay. Maybe add a little bit more. B for the brush tool, something like that. Overlay, maybe reduce the opacity to 40%. And now we need to group this and name the group BG from background. And that's it for the background for now. This is our burger. And we need to make some changes to it. I'm not sure what I originally made, but I know that I added some brightness and contrast. All the changes that we will do on these sliders needs to be clipped to the burger. So we need to press this or hold Alt and click between these two layers. Okay, so let's add some contrast. Okay, add some brightness. Contrast. Something like that. We need to have more vibrance on the colors. So add the vibrance adjustment layer. Clip it down below. And just add some vibrance. This will bring more color into our picture. Next, go to the selective color and let's make some adjustments. Just play with it. It's not an exact science. See what looks best for you. I'll fast forward for you. Okay, so this is how it looks after I applied the selective color adjustment. Let's add another adjustment layer, curves, to bring some green in the pixels. Okay, while selecting the layer mask, controller command I to hide the adjustments. B for the brush tool, go to foreground white, reduce the size of the brush and paint on the pixels. As you see, they become with a lot more color. Obviously, the selection of the burger is not perfect. It still has a fringe, but you can make more adjustments on your own. So we just made the pickles more green. Let's use the same procedure for the tomatoes. Curves, clip it, select red, increase here in the middle. Select layer mask, controller command I to invert. So we had hide all the adjustments. B for the brush tool, white, choose the proper opacity and paint over the tomatoes. Okay, so that's about all. As you can see, before and after, after and before, before and after. Okay. It's not a huge improvement, but it looks a bit better. Now let's blend a little bit better the burger with the background. B for the brush tool, Alt to select a color from the background. Now you can see it's another color selected. Make the brush bigger and paint here. This way we can blend the burger with the background a little bit better. Use a different blending mode. Let's say overlay. Select a new layer, the same, use the background color and try to blend the buns of the burger better with the background. Okay, add a new layer, hold Alt and clip it down below. Go to edit, fill and 50% gray. Choose soft light as a blending mode. Go to B for the brush tool, lower the opacity like 10% and the flow like 28%. D, and now we have to touch and burn this burger. So we make the burger more dynamic, will pop even more in our image. So lower your brush size and start painting with black for shadows. I'll fast forward this for you. Now switch it to the white foreground. We will paint with white and we'll increase our highlights. I'll forward this for you and I'll see you after everything is done. Okay, I have finished with the dodge and burning before and after, before and after. Do you see how the look improved after this technique? I think we should reduce the opacity for the selective color adjustment, maybe around 70%. I think it's better that way. So this is the burger folder. Control or command G to make a folder and rename it burger. I think we can make a small improvement to this picture. Right click and choose convert to smart object. Go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Choose a very small blur, like around the one. Go to this layer mask and press control or command I to hide the adjustment. Go to B for the brush tool, foreground color white, and choose a small opacity and bring that blur back to this wooden table so that our focus should be on the burger itself and less on this table. So here is the adjustment. Here is where we applied the Gaussian blur. It's not a huge adjustment, but it has a subtle effect that help us. We can always change the amount of blur. As you can see, maybe we should add more, like 2% before and after. And you can make changes on the layer mask to bring up some of the blurness when having the white selected, or to take back when you have the black foreground. Okay, so it's not a very major change, but it adds to the effect. Okay, let's move forward. Let's add a frame here. Let's go to U, or click here on the rectangle tool. Choose, go to fill, no fill, and add a stroke around 5 pixels, let's say. We can change after. So here is our frame, Control Command A, and center it. Let's move it a little bit up. Now move the frame behind the burger folder. And this is our frame. This is our frame. Let's group it. Control Command G. Let's call it frame. And now press on the layer mask. Go to the brush tool B. I have some brushes here, distress texture brushes, that we will going to apply on this frame. Just choose a brush. I have plenty of distressed texture brushes. You can find your own, or apply a vector based texture. So while selecting the layer mask with the black foreground color, just click where you want this brush to apply, and you will see the effect it has on the frame borders, like that. You can use either black or white color, like so. Okay, something like that. Okay, so let's say we are finished for now. This is our frame. If you want to see how this layer mask applied to our frame, hold Alt and click on the layer mask. This is our brush that created this distressed effect on the frame. Look how it was before. Hold Shift and see without the effect and with the effect. Okay, so now let's add our text. Go for T for the type tool. Let's begin with the our text. Control Command A, center it. Go to the type panel, word text, and let's use arc upper. Like so, maybe like that. Let's make the type smaller. Let's make the type smaller, like so. Control Command A and center it. We can change this later if we want to. Go to P for the pen tool, select shape, not pad. For the stroke, no stroke. Let's make a shape. Hold Shift, like so. A, maybe make a little bit bigger. And try to center it. Okay, Control A, center it. This is our shape. Go for T for the type tool. And type on this pad. Okay, A, to center the text, to align it on the center, make the text a little bit bigger. Okay, maybe a little bit smaller, 100, even less, 90, something like that. Go to the type, warp text, choose arc, let's say lower, and bend this, let's say minus 10, 20, make the spacing minus 10, and let's leave it as it is. Now let's add the last final text, burger. Okay, make it a little bit bigger, maybe even more. And now go to type, warp text, arc upper, and use a bend like 50%. It's not perfect like I did in the first place because I had more time, but I just want to demonstrate for you what you should do in order to achieve similar results. It's a lot of back and forth, and you should know that from the beginning. Don't rush any of your graphic design work. Was this is our group controller command GG, and rename it title or something similar. Let's add a little bit of elements like these arrows in our design. Let's make it bigger. Let's place these arrows like so. Double click on the layer and go to color overlay and choose your color white. Like so. Let's add this heart element in our design. Make it a little bit smaller. Right click, rasterize layer, control command T to transform, and choose distort. Maybe like so. Okay. We can add some blur. Let's see, Martian blur. Maybe like that. Okay, let's leave it as it is. Duplicate this, Control Command J. Control Command T to flip it horizontally. Let's place it somewhere around here. Group this and call them heart. Let's change the heart colors by applying an adjustment layer, hue saturation. Clip it down below and change the hue. Now it's looking much better. Okay, go to the frame. And maybe make this a little bit taller. Hold shift. Okay. This is better. Adjust the title. Okay. And now just add the final touch. Go to rectangle tool. Choose rectangle tool. Like so. Don't clip it. Choose a red color, not sure which one. Let's go with that, or maybe a little bit like that. Okay, this is the hex color. Make it smaller and like so. U for the rectangle tool. And just change the corners here, input 10 or 20 to make it rounded, 20 here also, like so. Add an icon that I already had in here prepared for you. Transform it, place it in this rectangle. While having the icon selected, Control or Command on the rectangle icon and now center it. Okay. Double click on the layer style, go to color overlay and choose a color from the background. Now group this together and let's call this logo. Make a layer mask. Go to B for the brush tool and do the same as we've done on the frame. Just add some texture here, like so. And I guess we are done with everything. This is our final image. Let me show my original design. This was my original design. So as you may see, it looks a little bit better than this one that I've done for you. I will link this burger image, just the stock photo, in the description down below. Please make sure to subscribe and comment on this video. I will also invite you to check Envato Elements subscription. They have huge collections of stock videos, sound effects, graphic templates, and all kinds of assets that every graphic designer should have. They have a really affordable pricing, starting around $16 per month. So you have to check this website. I will leave a link down below. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment, and I will be seeing you next time.